Welcome back and welcome to Microbial Genetics. Here in this video, I will talk about conjugation and how this process applied to construct chromosomal map of E. coli. Conjugation is a natural process whereby DNA transferred through direct contact between a donor cell and a recipient bacterial cell. This process was discovered by Lederberg and Totum in 1946. They found that if donor and recipient bacterial culture are mixed, recombinant cells are appeared. That means progeny cells are unique and they are different genetically from both donor as well as from the recipient. Contact is necessary for this process, which is mediated by sex pili synthesized by the donor cell. They also possesses a fertility factor called a plasmid that is actually transferred to the recipient. Here, donor cells are called male or A plus cells and recipient cells are called F minus or female. The F minus cells do not contain any A plasmid. A plasmid is a large, around 100 kb size, extrachromosomal DNA. It contains all the necessary informations for DNA transfer in this region. It's called traoperon. It also contains informations for pili formation. A short segment called oriT helps in transfer process. During transfer, a single strand break is initiated at this region and one strand of the double-stranded DNA is ready for transfer. 5' end of the strand enter into the recipient first and 3' end serve as a primer for the replication. As more and more DNA entered into the recipient cell, a new DNA strand is being synthesized, taking other strand as template. When a plasmid transfer is completed, mating pair is break and the recipient cell synthesize the other or complementary strand to make it double-stranded DNA, just like the A plus cell. Now A minus cells become A plus cells and able to transfer its A plasmid to other A minus cells. Most of the cases A plasmid is free, but sometimes it is integrated into the chromosome. There are three transposable elements present in this region, two copies of IS3 and one copy of each, gamma delta and IS2. If same IS elements present in the bacterial chromosome, it is integrated in this way. The interesting thing is that when a plasmid is in integrated state, it can able to transfer chromosomal genes, resulting large number of recombinant cells. That's why those cells are called HFR or high frequency recombination. Another interesting thing is that a plasmid can integrate at different locations in the chromosome and in different orientations. So different HFR cells initiate chromosomal gene transfer in different order, depending on its integration site and its orientation. In this example, the red arrow is a plasmid and only four genes are shown in the chromosome for simplicity. Gene which is situated very close to the oriT will transfer first, then second, third and so on. And if we interrupt the mating process at certain interval using kitchen blender and scored which gene or genes enter into the recipient, then it is possible to determine the gene order depending on their time of entry. For example, if we interrupt mating process of these HFR cells and F minus cells at 5 minutes, then only gene 12 will enter. At 10 minutes, gene 3 will enter. Then we can conclude that gene 12 is situated very close to oriT. First, then gene 3 is present, and how far they are? The distance between 12 and 3 is 10 minus 5 or 5 minutes. At 15 minutes, gene 6 will enter, so third gene is 6. And at 20 minutes, gene 9 will enter, so 9 is situated last. So the map will be like this. This process is called interrupted mating, and the map is called minute map. Now it's time to solve some numerical problems. In this problem, the order of gene transfer for 4 HFR cells are given in this table. From these informations, you have to determine the correct gene order and the orientations of the HFR integration sites. We can see that the order of gene transfer in HFR1 is started from gene A and the last gene is H. So HFR integrated just before the gene A. The second gene is B and third D and fourth F and the last one is H. In this way, I have drawn the order of gene transfer in HFR 2, 3 and 4. Then I have aligned them in this way. Notice that in order to fit properly, I have to invert both HFR 2 and HFR 3. But I don't rearrange the gene order. So if you read the gene from left to right, it will produce this gene order. Now again observe that the two ends are repeated twice. That means the DNA is circular and the map will look like this. And in this problem, 3 HFR cells are used and order and time of entry are given. From these informations, you have to construct the map and respective distance in minute between two genes. Look carefully how I found the distance and the order of gene transfer in HFR1. It takes 3 minutes for the entry of gene B. That means B gene is situated 3 minutes away from the oriT. Then gene D enter into the F minus cell. That means D is situated next to gene B. And from oriT, the distance of gene D is 5 minutes. So the distance between B and D is 5 minus 3 or 2 minutes. In this way, I have calculated the distance between each genes in all 3 cases. Then, like before, I have aligned them all. And here I have to invert the sequence 2 or HFR2 in order to fit it. So the final map is look like this. I hope now you can solve any problem from this topic. Feel free to post your comment in this section, like and share if you find this video helpful for your exam preparation. And most important of all, if you like to support me and my channel so I can make more videos like this, then subscribe my channel and thanks for watching.